to book 2 months out. I don't have to like do anything. It's awesome. I'm gonna turn this down just a teeny bit. There we go. So April, Danny, Carrie, who else is coming? Who wants to move today? Little bit of flow, little bit of yin. It's like the perfect class. I know that I feel like I want that right now to fill my body. So allow yourself to be here. Allow yourself to be here. Lift the shoulders, relax the shoulders. Big breath in. Big breath out. I miss you guys. I can be here with you now. You see me. I just don't see you, but I feel your energy. I hope everybody's been in this place of
gratitude.
And if you tend to fluctuate with the craziness that's happening outside,
it is a reminder when you feel uncomfortable inside, it is a reminder that we can create our own sacred little containers. I believe that's why we are in our own homes now, so we can kind of take ourselves into a sacred space. We only allow what we allow to come in, that's it. And so if you're dousing yourself with negativity and news and fear, and that's bringing all this stuff up, you get to choose to
shut it off or click it off. So for me, probably haven't had the TV on for
4 or 5 days, maybe. I think it's been
5 days. What is today? Tuesday? Yeah. So there's no need for any of that stuff to come at you. Nothing has shifted. We're staying home. We're staying healthy. We're breathing. We're moving. We have all kinds of gifts
that are here for us.
So as you take a breath in, just acknowledge your sweet, sacred self. And then your sweet, sacred space. Maybe you rolled out your mat.
Maybe you have this little area here where we can kind of
tune in to what we want to cultivate for the next hour together. So I have a breath session scheduled tomorrow at 11 a.m.
Tomorrow is the 1st of April.
We are homebound
for at least another month is what they're saying. And then also we might get, just to give you a heads up, interference with our phone or our internet. So like I said in this meditation this morning, how will that test you when you can't reach out?
So it's even a deeper pulling in, right? So don't flip out, it's going to happen. At least for 3 days, and you're going to sit in your house, not flipping out,
and taking breaths,
and picking the most amazing book that you have in yourself,
and picking up and opening it up and noticing that that version of whatever's on that page, there's a message there for you. If you have, if you're a tarot reader or a card reader, you could pick a card. Everything is going to be okay. It has to happen.
And we're resilient.
And we're strong. And we can be vulnerable. And
we can learn the courage and the vulnerability.
And
we can relax. And
know everything is being taken care of exactly how it needs to. It's the awakening.
And so there's a part of me that's
like, and then there's a part of me that's like, let's celebrate. Because when you come out of this, we're going to know such a deeper self of a deeper sense of ourselves that we've never met before. And so
right hand to the heart, left
hand to the belly, begin to feel the light within inside
you and around you. And as that light emits a greater flame
for you to burn off impurity,
to burn off the fear, to burn off the anxiety, the worry, the uneasy, we draw a breath in. And about ourselves when we tune in. There's more truth inside of how we feel about stuff than there is outside of us. So look and observe where you're watching. If you turn inward, you're going to get the best messages. If you reach outward to all of these sources outside of you, there's going to be some problems, and it's going to create some kind of uneasiness inside. So we want to stay peaceful and calm. It's really, really important at this time. Also, right after this class, I want you to take a candle, light it, and set it outside your porch or your front door for peace.
There's people all around the world.
It's an initiative to
sit quietly. So, of course, after your shavasana, just light
a little candle and set it outside your door. And let
everybody know that we're in this together and we're lighting
the way for new beginnings.
New awarenesses, new truths. A new invitation inside. I'm drawing about here.
Prayer of the heart.
Let's light the flame inside us right now. Light it up. Light it up with your breath. Use this light with intention. Intention to be present. Intention to be peaceful. Intention to be strong. You can melt away all those things that make you feel a little uneasy that you may be hanging on to. Not that it's bad to feel uneasy.
It's bad to
hang on to the uneasiness. It's bad to create a story around the uneasiness. So if you're sad, be sad. Process it. Everything is impermanent and temporary. So it comes and goes. It comes and goes. And so we're going to play that. We're going to play that with
our flow in the vinyasa part of the class.
Mm-hmm. Inhale, lift the arms
all the way up. Exhale, release them all the way down. Touching the forehead, the lips, in the heart center. And as we take a breath in, lift up again.
And then exhale, take it down. Forehead, lips, and heart. Feel the breath come in. Arm reach high. And then
as the breath comes out, forehead, lips, and heart.
Inhale, lift all the way out wide.
And exhale, round and down.
Inhale, lift the right arm off and
turn to the left.
And then take the right arm down. Inhale, open wide. Exhale, close. Left arm lift up and open. Exhale to close. Open wide. Close. Exhale, close. Right arm up
and
open. Exhale, release. Inhale, left arm. Feel the beautiful maybe motion in your shoulders.
And take it down.
Open wide. And close. One more right arm off. Open. And take it back. And meet the left. Inhale, left arm up. And exhale back. One more time to open. This time, cactus your arms. Interlace your fingers as you reach high. Exhale, point the fingers, your women, your thumb on the left comes out on top.
If you're male, the thumb on the right comes out and on top. Breath of fire.
Pump your belly.
Stoking that fire, that flame that you lit earlier. Keep going. It's lit and infused with intention and presence.
Mm-hmm. on this last inhale, hold here.
Eyes up, prana.
Lift the perineum up, mula bandha, uddiyana bandha, navel in. You set back, straighten your leg. Maybe
you're going to kind of
shake those out a little bit, massage those out. Right leg crosses up and over the left. Turn and twist. Over the right straight leg, lift and lengthen, twist and rotate on the exhale. Keep the right toes flexed on the right foot and squeeze and hook into that twisting spine. Find your breath to lengthen on the inhale.
And
bound angle. Bottoms of the feet come together, knees apart.
Inhale, lift up. Exhale, fold forward. Inhale, lift up halfway, lengthen through the crown. Move your head between your arms and lean forward in a straight line. And then slowly release. Inhale to lengthen again. This time, if there is a possibility that you can do this, take the hands to the inner knees, lean forward, roll back your shoulders,
tuck your chin in,
and slowly begin to fold straight spine. Just a little self-adjustment. You're not pushing or forcing anything, it's just the heaviness of your arms. Everything is intentional. You're not forcing or pressing anything. You're being safe. Inhaling,
coming back to the center. Straightening the legs, lifting the arms all the way up. You're going to slide your hands or press your hands down to the back of the hips. Fingertips face the hips. Inhale, lift the heart. Push into the feet and arch.
Lift the hips up a little higher
if you can.
And exhale, release.
Straighten the legs, inhale, and then exhale, float forward. So you're in a forward fold. Feet are both flexed back as the heels press out. Inhale, look up halfway. Exhale, fold.
Inhale, halfway.
Exhale, fold.
Reach and rise all the way up.
This time you're going to reach back and do the same thing, or is reverse table, bend your knees, or you could try this next one with a straight leg. Inhale.
Come all the way up. Lift the hips, opening, and exhale, releasing back down.
So drawing a nice big deep breath. Exhale, swan, diving all the way down. Come to the feet.
And then I want you to take wide legs, tap with your left or right, like whatever you can do to face the screen, just the left knee, lining the feet up, drawing yourself to a forward fold. Crown of the head reaches to the side, or to the floor, and the hips are high to the side, reaching out the outer edges of your apex. Inhale, look up halfway as you press to the front of the feet or ankles or shins, and then fold forward again. Inhale, look up halfway, slide the left hand underneath the chin, peel the right arm up. Exhale, again. Left arm peels off as the right arm replaces that hand. Exhale, fold back down. Walk the hands all the way over to the right. Pivot, turn the right foot to the short edge of your mat. I know that you might have to adjust a little bit. Drop the back knee down. Inhale, come all the way. Exhale, find your prayer twist. Hooking the left elbow to the right knee. Throwing the left toes under, lifting the knee. And then backing yourself up as you unwind fingertips underneath the shoulder. Straight right leg. Straight left leg, square the hips. You might have to shift around a little bit. And once you square the hips, take a nice big deep lunge in the right knee and inhale, come up wide, deep, on the exhale. Good, deep lunge. Inhale, come back to center. So you're facing the long edge of your mat again. This time your hands on your hips. Inhale. Interlace the fingers behind the back.
And release.
Shoulders. If your heart hurts on your knees, Michael Bendon. Move the shoulders away from the ear. Inhale, release. Press the fingertips halfway. Look up.
Flat back. Exhale. Hold again.
And then walk your hands to the left side.
Pivot. Turn your left toes to the back of the mat, which should be the back of your mat.
Or maybe you're in a funky position
like me.
So straight leg,
drop the knee, inhale with the under.
Good. Exhale, prayer,
and twist to the left. Looking the right up or left knee.
Curling the toes under,
inhale lifting knee.
Coming back, straightening the foot,
straightening both legs, bowing forward over the left.
Inhale, deep bend in the left knee.
And come up. On the knee, across the left.
Good. Taking a nice big deep breath here. And exhale. Straighten the left leg, walking
forward again.
Wide leg forward, fold.
Release.
Inhale, halfway lift. Left hand underneath the chin, peeling the right arm up. So release the right arm to replace the left arm, lifting the left arm up. Exhale, slowly lower down, folding again deep.
Maybe you're coming onto your forearm.
Exhale.
Inhale, halfway lift, walking to the front edge of your mat or where your right foot would be framed, right?
Exhale, stepping
back towards first downward facing.
So as you take a breath here,
feel and inhale.
And in exhale. Inhale to plank pose. And exhale to downward facing. Step in with your left foot
a little bit and lift your right leg all the way up. Wide. Bend the knee.
Take a nice big deep breath. If it's reachable for you, flip it up. Yeah. If it's not, just open and bend that hip and then lower it back down. You can make this as much or as little of a flow as you want. To be challenging or easy depending on what's going on. Last leg left arm.
Open up.
Flip it out if it's accessible for you today. If not, just lift and open and then come back to the center. Beautiful. Jump down onto the knee. And then inhale, cat pose. And remember, our under the shoulder line up, knees under the hips, line up. Breathing in. Breathing out. Right leg comes straight back, curl the toes under. And see if you can push firmly in and ground through the feet, or the right foot, toes, and both hands, each finger. And lifting. Shoot that left foot. Top of the plank. Chaturanga slowly lower down. And if that isn't accessible for you, you can always do the modified version where you drop the knees first. Lower slow and straight, elbows straight up. Exhale back, cat cow. Slide the hands in step. Inhale. Straighten the left leg, curling the toes under, pushing firmly into each palm, each finger, and lift the right knee up. And then straighten that right leg back here and plank pose. Fullness of the back body, lower slow. Even knees down, heads of the shoulders stay up, they don't sink. Push into the feet and float your legs if you can find it upward facing dog. Maybe a little sphinx or cobra feels better for your body today. And then lower back, hips to heels, child's pose, take a breath. You can rock, giving yourself a little frontal cortex massage. You can bend the elbows and take a prayer to forgive all the things that you may need to forgive for the last few days.
Maybe you've been hard on yourself.
Maybe there's been some negativity
that's affected you.
Just give yourself a little forgiveness. Release those arms down, curl the toes under, lift back up to downward facing dog. Walking
those feet up towards the hands.
Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, fold.
Inhale, rise and reach all the way up. And look a little back bend here. You get to decide that too. And then slowly lowering down. My head is totally cut off. Crazy.
Inhale, reach high. Swan dive down. Halfway lift.
Exhale.
Stepping the left leg back, coming to the long edge of your mat. Folding forward.
Inhale, press halfway up.
One more. Left arm down. Peel the right arm up.
Exhale, release. And switch. Left arm high. Exhale, release back down. And see if you can grab and reach for the outer ankle.
Find yourself in this forward fold, letting gravity do the work for you.
Inhaling, legs
coming through the plank. And for me, I have a long torso, so I'm going to shorten my stance a little bit.
And let my head
lengthen, neck lengthen, cervical spine,
thoracic spine, lumbar spine. Inhale, slowly rise.
Taking the hands back underneath the shoulders. Heel toe your feet in. Another foot or so. You're going to be hip distance apart with the ankles or the heels.
And kick the toes outward.
Inhale, coming back. And so we're going to find prayer again. And we're going to take the inner parts of the knees.
And you press the elbow right there.
Yeah, so you're opening and broadening through the deep hip opener from both sides with the help of your elbows. And I like to spread my fingers apart, my palms apart, so I can deepen it even more.
And then inhale,
let's take the left fingertips to the floor and the right arm up, so a little twister.
Inhale, come back to the center, and switch. Left arm high,
and right fingertips ground.
Exhale, release. So if you want to play with this, because we are in a vinyasa flow, you can lift the hips up,
you can shift the feet back around hip distance apart. As you bend your elbows, this becomes a shelf. So a lot of people will squeeze outer parts of the arm and in. I like to come on top. And I like to get really
up high toward the armpit. So if that feels more comfortable for you, the triceps that you're pressing on, the fingertips are open, they're pressing, you're grounded, your tushy is as light as a feather. And as you lift up, I like to come down. Some people kind of do this thing, and you can do that too, find your balance. And play with that a little bit, coming back. And then dropping the hands down to ground and walking back. Downward facing up. Exhale to plank. Exhale to drop the knees. Come into cat cow. One more. Straightening the left leg, curl the right toes under, straightening the right leg. You're on the top of a push-up or plank. You're going to either drop the knees and modify, slowly lowering, and then coming up to an upward facing dog or a pose. And if you want to press firmly, you can kind of open a little more. You can shake, you can sway, and then drop slowly down to the lower rib. Take the hands to the sides of the body, and then when you're ready, lift the heart, lift the shoulders, lift the head, squeeze the feet together, and lift. Inhale a little more. So take a moment and cross your arms and take a breath and rest. Notice what way your head is turned. Because we're going to do this again, and you're going to rest turning the opposite way. Inhale, come back, lift the head gently, or you can take the chin to the floor. Settle your hands again, palms facing up alongside your hips and legs. Squeeze the bones with the big toes together, or inner thigh leading the legs. Lift. Lift the heart, lift the shoulders, lift the head, lift the chin. Open. Beautiful. Cross the arms and turn your head to the opposite direction and take a few breaths. One of the same breath, just for a few more. Relaxing below or ujjayi. Inhale, come back to center, then go one more. That one more can be a little bit deeper. You can bend your knees, and you can just take a moment and sway them side to side. Yeah. And you could reach back. Inhale, press yourself up. You could grab the front of your ankles, your feet, and then press back. And as you take your feet back, there is a back bend that opens. Slowly press back to child pose. It's a nice, beautiful counter pose just to round out that lumbar spine. And again, a frontal cortex massage. Couple more breaths here. Allowing yourself to tap into that inner light that you've ignited, and that flame is burning a little brighter. Inhale, pressing back up. Let me see. Come back at the time. We're in perfect time. So relax into, let's see. Let's come into a simple spinal twist. We're going to do it face down now. So as you move to the both knees to the left side of your mat, right, drop your hips to the right, and then lower slowly down. This is a spinal twist face down. Bring the arms straight up. So see if you can get there, right? I'm going to scoot back just a little bit. See if you can get there. Knees are close up into the navel, and then you're lowering and slowly releasing back into the rhythmic breath.
hands can be face down. Now your head is going to be turned to the left, resting on the right cheek, because it's the easiest option for your neck. But if there's a possibility for you to turn to the right, checking into the range of motion in your neck, then you can kind of play with that a little bit. You can take a breath and move into that limited range of motion, facing the right side.
So I'm coming up out of the pool, you stay in it. So yin yoga is
labeled as yin yoga to open the joints,
the fascia, the tendons, the ligaments.
And it starts at 3 minutes. The benefit starts at 3 minutes.
So as you take a breath in and out, feel yourself settling.
This is one of the most favorite classes
at the studio, which I miss very much.
It seems like every day I pick a different room to do yoga in, and I haven't found one that I absolutely love.
You know why? Because it's not here. It's at the studio.
And so I'm so grateful.
Like, I'm so grateful.
And that this is also temporary.
But I'm embracing all of it. Like, it's really beautiful to be able to experience
something different, because it's not something that we would ever raise our hand and sign up for, going, yeah, I'm going to go do, you know, be at home and keep yoga.
Mine, that would be not. I love presence. I love touching people. I love being with you. So this is difficult on everyone. So we have to allow the process to be as it is and accept it and open our heart to it and make it the best possible thing. Just like we call
resilience, right? We settle into compassionate, deeper
understanding that this is temporary, right?
Just like the sensations you might feel. Imagine yourself wringing
out, taking just one more breath.
Open your mouth.
Bend your elbows, slide your palms under your shoulders, press yourself back up. And as you press yourself back up, you'll press your knees back underneath. If you need a little cat cow, you can do that. Maybe move your spine.
If you want to release
and sit up and shake it out a little bit, or maybe you just want to hold still for a second and notice how that goes.
I feel like we get more peaceful and more present each day we're in quarantine. More peaceful and more present each day. And I think it's a gift. Right? I think it's a gift. Taking a breath. Good. We're coming back onto the hands and knees.
Your knees will now draw all the way over to the right part of your yoga mat. Left hip will go down. You're inhaling, and then exhaling, slowly lowering all the way down to the chest.
Find the arms up,
palms facing down.
Take a breath and surrender. And as you relax down, you're unwinding. You're giving this new, fresh
pressure and energy as we release and breathe into the navel center. A massage and new blood flow for the internal organs.
So breathing in and out through the belly here.
Taking a few breaths. Breathing in and out through the belly. Line up.
We're on the second side as you step straight up. Breathing in and breathing out. And just feeling the connection to that. And feeling the surrender in the physical body and the observing. How can you observe the thoughts that come and go, that rest and go? So a couple more breaths. Inhaling and exhaling. This is for your nervous system, your digestive system, it's for your hips, it's for your inner thoracic, it's for your shoulders, it's for your back, it's for your neck. So the easiest way to turn, right?
Try to play with that neck adjustment, where you can turn one way, and it's easy.
Which would be the right side, but
maybe you could turn to the left a little bit and check in with the range of motion. Are you stuck? Are you tight?
Do you have lack of range of motion? Can you open in a subtle, beautiful, soft way, nurturing and taking care of yourself. Just a couple more times. If you missed the meditation this morning, I did a healing meditation, and it was for ourselves and the planet. So drawing a big breath in, you can go back, Facebook Live, and watch any of these videos. There's a yin, something else, a slow flow, you know. Breath sessions tomorrow, 11 a.m. You can call me or not with me if you're going to come. I'll give you the password to get into the Zoom. Couple more breaths. Changing and relaxing into a heavy, effortless
feel in the body.
And a witnessing, observing from the mind. Connected breath or belly breath in the navel center, rising and falling, massaging internal organs. Today is your day to lift the heaviness that
you've been feeling
and come into a lighter feeling, igniting the light inside, burning away all that holds you back and holds you down. You don't have to focus on all the other things that people are fearful of. You are strong, you are resilient, you have an amazing immune system, you have an amazing intelligence system called our bodies, and we trust it. Remember, what you focus on is fear. And if you're focusing on how bad this is,
then you're just going to get more of that. And it's going to swirl around until it actually makes you sick.
And if you've read Biology of Belief by Bruce Lipton, they're called mind memes. You can actually literally create yourself to be sick. It's like you call in the virus. You don't want to do that. But you can call in your health, and you can call in
your peace, and you can call in your healing, and you can
call in your serenity. You can call in your yoga practice, your inner guru and wisdom, and work so closely with the intuitive nature of who you really are. One more breath. Open up, let it go.
Time is
now for you to feel good. Slowly, slowly, start to bend the elbows. Draw them under the shoulders.
Pick yourself up. Walk those knees back to center. Maybe
if you can't tell, maybe you just want to lay on your belly for a minute. Maybe you want to back up to child pose. There's so many different ways to move
your body.
Or to rest, or to feel, and acknowledge what
that pose has brought you.
What did it bring you?
And sometimes you want to just bring blood flow back to those areas, or you want to massage, or you want to hold still, to notice, to feel what needs to be there for you. Inhaling again. Exhaling.
We're going to do a quick breath work before the next one. So draw the knee. I like to be on the knees for this one.
So take an inhale. And an exhale. I worked with this not yesterday, but the day before, Sunday
morning.
And we did a
strengthening of the diaphragm.
So this breath, let's
just do 10. We'll just do 10.
It's an inhale with half closed
nostrils. So you take your hand, maybe your thumb and first finger, and you close halfway, and you inhale. And there's a little bit of resistance in there, and it strengthens the diaphragm. And then exhale, both nostrils open.
And again, second time.
Exhale.
Third. Exhale. Fourth. Yeah. one more. Inhale all the way up, breathe all the way up. All the way up. Hold the breath at the top of the inhale. Holding. Recovery breath, inhale all the way up. Hold it for 15 seconds, just 15. The short hold. See if you can notice your heartbeat. Exhale, release. Beautiful, on to the next one. You're going to lie face up or down, totally up to you. You're going to come to the all the way to the left side of your mat. And then we're going to draw the feet to the right corner. And then we're going to lower slowly down, lifting our arms up over the head and scooting our upper body over also to the right edge. So feet, shoulders, and arms are to the right side of the mat. This is a banana asana, we call it in yin, and it opens up deep into the iliopsoas. It opens up the low back, the QL muscle, oblique. It'll help the low back release to, if your hamstrings, not your hamstrings, your IT bands are tight. So begin to notice if you need a little blanket or pillow under that left shoulder, or maybe you want to support the back of your head or neck. You're not rolling. You're staying flat on the back. And you're taking a few breaths. You can cross the ankles if that feels more comfortable. For me, I'm going to cross the feet. There's an outside raking and I can feel that this side is really tight for me. So I'm going to stay in this pose in surrender with you. Feeling the ebb and flow of my breath. Noticing sensation in the body and softening a little more. Softening a little more. Relaxing into the heaviness of grounding and letting go. And just surrendering a little vulnerability in you. That vulnerability is all about courage. It's not about being weak. It's about having a courageous heart to be here authentically, letting things happen in ways that you can't control. Okay? Just let them happen. Without your opinion, without your complaining, without your worrying around it and concerns around it. But just to witness it. There's always something behind everything that happens. Trusting the process. That's what I watch. Trusting the process. Doing our best.
Take the body back, unwinding slow.
Yes, settling in.
Maybe
you need the knees into the chest. Maybe a little rock for that little back.
I definitely can tell that I've been raising a little bit today.
Maybe you want to wiggle your knees around. Maybe you want to press up to a little bridge. You kind of notice where the space is now. And then you're going to draw your whole body
over to the right edge of the yoga mat. And you're going to take the right foot to the right and the left foot to the right. Inhale, lift it up. And exhale, kind of scooting your whole torso over, staying flat on your back.
Sometimes we use our little prop board and we lay in a side
lying position to open hands.
And sometimes we do the face down, but we can also do it like.
And I like to take my hand on the right behind the back of my head so it can stay.
Yes, tight shoulders, beautiful way to open the shoulders, non-effort.
Yin is non-effort. We don't do anything here. We get
into a pose and we let go. We let go and surrender
in the deepest
version that we can. Whatever is going on in our world right now,
this is a lot.
So give yourself a break and let yourself settle into however you're feeling. Especially now, you might notice there's emotions that arise when you're in a safe, sacred space in your own home now, where if something comes up and you need to cry,
or yell, or pound the floor, or release something more,
then let the posture
being, let it come out, let it bubble up.
Give yourself permission to do all that needs to be done right here. This is just healing practice, let your body heal. Exploring the inner depth, right? Exploring the inner depth. Our bodies
remember everything.
We don't forget anything. So if there's something that you haven't processed, if there's something that you stressed and stored away, not wanting to talk about it or deal with it,
it
will haunt you and eat you alive. So that's not a fear thing, that's the truth. So we take a breath in and we feel that it's in there somewhere. If you have chronic
pain or
a problem that keeps showing up, it's probably that that's manifesting something. So as we feel all that we need to, breathing in and out, and just honoring all of the processing that can be done. All the feelings. And in yoga, in a breath session, I'll say, feel it to you. Sometimes we don't know where it comes from or what it's really about, but it's just an emotion. And it comes up. And when it comes up and we feel and experience it, then it can leave and we have less power over it. So this is a deep process. It's not just a physical opening the body. The body is the most densest area, so we resonate with it the most because we see it in the man. But you have your energy body, your spirit body, your emotional body, your mental body. And in your really call them close. And so we acknowledge all of the movements. A beautiful sweet sound. And we want to purify and affect all of them. Inhale, last breath. Slowly, slowly begin to draw yourself
and your torso back to center, letting those legs maybe one leg at a time and settling back in. Now what feels right? Maybe a happy baby
grabbing the bottom of your
feet, rocking that low back out. This is really good
effect of low back because you've had some chronic stuff. You're definitely going to do some work there. Or maybe it's just hugging in. Maybe again it's that bridge. And inhale. See if you can roll up first. And as you roll up, extend yourself a seated position. And as you sit, slide side to side,
removing the flesh from your sit bones.
Sit up nice and tall. And begin to feel this breath all the way from the crown of the head,
come all the way in the body.
Like this healing white light that comes in and flushes down the bottom of the leg. And then I want you to leave the white light here.
And the next time you inhale, I want you to bring it all the way up your feet into the leg, breathing all the way up and in,
out through the crown of the head.
And that white light goes all over to every being that's especially struggling, right?
That's especially struggling and wrapped in so much fear that this white light is giving them some kind, some little sense, even if it's just
a bit of peace.
Of peace. Slowly, slowly fold forward. And as you fold forward, relax your feet.
Shake them out a little bit. Relax your arms, relax your shoulders, relax your head. Shake it out. And be wherever you land. Maybe you want a little prop.
Or support. For me, I don't have anything
around me at the moment. But I'm just going to hang and let gravity do the work for my yin person.
And so, as you release down a little more, then go ahead and walk your hands out.
And
you can move your legs if you're starting to sink down and your belly's in the way or the legs in the...
Open the legs up a little bit.
Yeah. You can just kind of sink in a little more. And then once you're here, commit to finding stillness. And last, it is a releasing deep into the pose. And your body releases and softens. The gravity takes hold of you and just draws you down close to your grounding to the floor, to the earth. So as you come into, I'm going to grab, like, I have real close by me, a towel. So I'm going to show you, this is like, at home, grab what you have near you, posture. So I'm going to roll this blanket or this towel up really tight. So as I roll it up really tight, voila, here's the top. So I'm going to take it along the spine. You also can take it across the bottoms of the shoulder blades. I don't know if you guys hear that, but the dog is trying to get in the room.
And the most challenging thing about teaching at home is these animals. I have three of them, and they feel like they have to be by us all the time. They love soaking up that energy of deep presence. So that's the towel where you need a long defined or crosswise like a T. Inhale, lift your arms up. Let your heart open and sink your head back. And if it's only like a gentle prop, like I have my wheel here, but there's you might be on a blanket or a pillow that would lift you a little more. If you feel like you need to support your head, I do not feel like I want to support my head. I want my throat open. I'm just going to relax back. So you can cactus your arms. You can lift them up over your head. You can feel the ebb and flow of your breath come back in now as you settle into stillness. Navigate more peacefully through each day that we're isolated, each day that we're out of our routine, each day that we're finding new ways to communicate and to move through our day, right? New ways. Breathing in and breathing out. Feeling that heart expanded space with each inhalation. Breathing in compassion. Breathing in wisdom. Breathing in this worthiness. Because without distraction and connection, we're all human. We feel there is a tendency to feel less worthy. You are worth all of the beautiful things. We're just experiencing a pause right now. So let that lessen
your anxiety
and your stress. There's lots of programs out there to help
you financially.
Feeling a release of worry. A release of heaviness. Open your heart to compassion. Taking the break, taking the pause, slowing down to come inside. This is a beautiful blessing. This is a beautiful blessing. We can stay stuck in the fear and say how horrible this thing is. Or we can understand that all of this is happening and so many people are getting healthy after they have the virus.
Their immune
systems are strong. Some, not so much.
But a lot, I think they said in the news that I get, which is
not some of the mainstream media stuff. So over 90%
of the people
are,
95 or 96% I think they said, are perfectly healthy and they survive this.
So drawing a breath in
of resilience, drawing a breath in of healing for yourself,
and as you exhale,
feel that exhalation
move out to the rest of the room. Feeling energy sent to everyone else, especially those people that are compromised, they're struggling. We don't want to see them struggle, we don't want to hear about them struggling, but what we can do is take our energy and our prayers and our
intentions and we can send that. Wrists around, take your arms out, draw them in, see if you can come up, press
you know, the elbows of our hands down to the floor as you come up.
Taking that prop to the side
and settling back down. You settle back down onto your back, maybe taking that little roll under your legs or your ankles or behind your neck. This would be a little too high for me, so I'd unwind it to roll to my neck. You can wrap yourself or cover yourself up with it if you have a blanket or a towel, and allow yourself to settle.
So what I've been doing, what
is called to me each time I teach online, is that I don't stay with you during your Shavasana.
I let you zone out
for as long as you need to.
So I am right
about here. So I let you rest for however long that you want to, because you're, again, in the sacred sanctuary of your own home,
the little yoga space that you've created. So I want to send out this healing love light in my
heart to you that is joining me today, or anybody else watching this at a later time. It's always safe on Facebook.
You can come back to it again. We have a breath session tomorrow. I'm going to go
light a candle and put it out on my front porch.
And set it on your front porch or deck
or by your door. This is
promoting the light of peace to all and the light of healing to all. So 7 o'clock is a, kind of like a spreading out to this, this global thing that everyone's doing. Your intention and your prayers are very powerful, and what you think is very powerful. So notice, I really, really challenge you to notice that if you're in that fear or in that left state, and just to stay away from the mass media that's telling us constantly.
All we're being inundated
with all of this stuff, and there's a lot of fear. We know how bad it is. We know. It's a pandemic. It's affecting every single country,
every single state,
every single area. We know this. We don't need to hear it over and over and over again. There's nothing
new that you're getting except more statistics,
and we're coming up onto
that
state where it could be coming down, and if we stay in this peaceful, calm place, we do more good than harm, right? We do more good by staying in a peaceful, healing state of mind and lifting our vibration to the place where we affect people in a positive way. So with that being said, I sink all of the energy into my heart, and I send it out in white light, and it could be God's clean love and light within inside of you. Universal light inside of you, sent out to every person, especially those who are struggling, especially the doctors and nurses, respiratory therapists, and all the people that are helping all of the sick people right now. We wrap them in love and light as well. But to stay in that vibration of healing and not get caught up in the fear. Because we can make the biggest difference in that way. From my heart to your heart, namaste. I love you guys. I'll see you soon. Thank you so much for sharing this time with me. Stay in Shavasana, relax as long as you need to. I love you. And I will see you soon, maybe tomorrow, for the breath session
at 11.